In the calendar, we have the option to create data locking tasks in addition to general tasks. Check out the video on managing calendar tasks and processes to learn more about general tasks. Data locking tasks are useful in the planning process when at different times we may want to enable or prevent users with planning permissions from making changes to values for a certain intersection of dimensions, such as those involved in quarterly product sales forecasts. Keep in mind that data locking tasks work only when the model has data locking turned on, and data locking owners are assigned for one or more dimensions. In this case, John is assigned as the data locking owner for all the members of the product dimension. Check out the video on data locking for more details about data locks in general. First, we'll define a title. We can choose whether to assign the task to our own user account. Next, we need to set the start and due dates for the task. We'll make the task due by the end of the day on Monday. We can add recurrence to support repeated activities like monthly or quarterly updates. By default, we're set to open the new task details automatically in the Designer panel. Now we can see the task details. One difference between general tasks and data locking tasks is that here, we can't assign common work files for assignees to work with. For data locking tasks, the assignee just needs to change the lock status, which they do by simply submitting the task. Any additional work can be assigned as a separate general task, or, as in this case, just described in the task title or description. Now we need to add context to specify the model and intersection of dimensions we're interested in changing the lock status for. In this case, we're interested in Q3 of 2019. Note that because John is the data locking owner only for members of the product dimension, we don't need to specify the product dimension here. When John submits the task, it will affect only the dimension members he's authorized to change the locks for. In the data locking area, we need to set the target status. In this case, we want John to set the status to restricted, which will let him enter values but keep them closed for other users. Next, we need to set John as the assignee. Update the task status. And then activate the task to notify John. In John's account, we've received a notification about the task. We can click the notification to view the task in the calendar. In the context area, we can see the model involved and the time range affected. When we submit the task, it will automatically change the lock status for the intersection of dimensions identified in the context, allowing us to update the Q3 product forecast as requested in the task title. Back in Joanna's account, we get a notification that the task has been completed. We can see that the current state of the context is now restricted. When we want the status change back to the default state of locked, we can assign John another task to make the change. Thanks for watching.